Okay. It is. Going up. Okay, that way they don't see her, okay. Did you guys enjoy that? Did you tell them I was doing that, and you were watching and seeing me?
Yeah, we were watching, but I didn't hear that. Okay, you should do it, ask them, who's driving?
We had, look, we were in here. Oh, nice. We were big. We were big. What do you say, anything else? What do you say, all right?
twice into the parlor. If you just go right over there near that stanchion post, right in front of the fireplace would be great. We can put some over this way, right near the door over there, near the radiator would be fine, right there. And you're good right there. So we are in the parlor of the 1820 section of the building, I mean the 1791 section. This would have been private space for the homeowner, not really open to guests of the tavern unless they were invited in. So I'm going to turn it over to Julie, who works for Transcend Paranormal, our investigative group, and she's going to talk a little bit about some of the things that we've done here at Paranormal.
Like he said, my name is Julie, and I am an investigator with Transcend Paranormal. We do a lot of investigations here. First off, welcome to the tavern. And yeah, we're in the parlor, which has served as a very prominent room when we investigate. We have so many buildings here on the tavern property that we can, travel against. We have the tavern, we have the courthouse, we have the jail. So like you said, we like to be reporters in one place while we go across the street to another. We've done that here, where we left a recorder here in the room, and we went across the street to investigate to the courthouse. Upon reviewing the recording, we heard some dragging noises coming throughout all of this room. That can't be explained because the tavern was locked. No one was able to come in here. On another occasion, we have events here all the time, a volunteer felt a touch of an unseen hand on her shoulder. Turned around, no one was there. And actually, only minutes later, another volunteer saw what she believed to be a woman in a long black Victorian period dress. And just seconds later, the woman completely vanished. Now the lady in black has been ever present here for a very long time, and she's still here today. And a long time inhabitant of the tavern many years ago actually said that she had seen her walking through the tavern on one occasion. Actually, just one of our staff members here, restaurant staff member, saw what she believed to be an apparition standing atop the stairs in the post office, which is another room we visited later, so it's not the another one, but not expecting anyone to be there. She kind of did a double take and the woman had vanished, unexplained. We're not sure if that's a lady in black or a completely different long-time resident here at the tavern. Now across the hall is an exhibit room that serves as kind of set up as a dining room now, but at one point it used to have Civil War type artifacts and things, valuable things like that that would need to be locked up at night. We were here investigating, and we suddenly hear loud crashes and bangs, and there's something being pushed off the tables or thrown against the wall. The room was locked, and then no investigator could go check it out. The following morning, when a staff member could finally open the door to see what we heard, what happened, nothing was out of place. Everything looked untouched. And that's a really neat recording and stuff that we all have. And, we haven't been able to investigate there for a long time, but we were able to just this past month. And we have a recording, EVP, which is an electric voice phenomenon. We can't hear it with our ears, but we can hear it with our recorder, of a man demanding us to get out. You remember it. Just the stairwell, too. Our last investigation that we did just about a couple weeks ago, someone was recording, holding a recorder going up, and they were upstairs, but they hear a whistling on the recorder. Like I said, you remember hearing someone whistle next to you. So that's really interesting.
All right, we're going to go through this door, turn right, and we're going to go up the steps to the next level. Take your time going up the steps. We'll gather at the landing at the very top. You can look across and see the dining room. Watch your step.
I ordered for me.
No, like he said, he's leaving a quarter and go someone else somewhere else, like across the street. Well, we've done that here. We left a quarter here in the parlor room while we go across the street to like investigate the courthouse and stuff. Upon reviewing that recording, we actually caught like dragging noise all throughout this room. When the tavern's locked, no one can come in, no one was inside at that time. So it's a really interesting piece of evidence. You're at the event now, made up of volunteers just like me. And one of our past events, a volunteer felt the touch of a woman, or not a woman, but an unsafe hand, touching her shoulder. And she's actually said no one was there. Minutes later, another volunteer came in here and she saw like a woman in a, best as she could describe it, is a black Victorian period dress just walking throughout. And seconds later, she had vanished.
Oh, fuck!
Be careful, they do wind up around the wall.